Hare Krishna. Spirituality reveals that our destiny is bigger than the biggest adversity. We all wish to achieve something wonderful in our lives. We all hope that there is something we are destined to do and that we do it and that we fulfill our potential, fulfill our destiny. Now, depending on the particular talents that we may have, we may envision our destiny in particular ways. I have musical talent, I want to become a great musician. I have physical ability, say somebody can play cricket nicely, I want to become a great cricketer. So we all envision our destiny in terms of particular talents, abilities we may have. However, sometimes adversities may come and cripple us. Suppose somebody wants to sing and somehow they lose their voice. What can they do then? That destiny is thwarted. Suppose somebody wants to play a sport and they lose their limbs. How can they play the sport then? So life can be cruel and adversity can just disrupt our plans and devastate us. What do we do at such times? The Bhagavad Gita reveals to us that our destiny is bigger than the biggest adversity. This destiny is based on our spirituality. We all may have certain abilities, but we are more than our abilities. We are souls. So, as souls, we are at our core spiritual beings. And as souls, we are meant to connect with the whole, with Krishna. The soul is indestructible. The soul's relationship with Krishna is eternal. Krishna's love for us is inalienable. Krishna never abandons us. So our destiny ultimately is to unite with Krishna in a bond of eternal love, eternal joy. And whatever specific abilities we have, we can use them in a mood of service to Krishna, in a mood of contribution and devotion. And we may get success, and that's wonderful. If we don't get success at the material level, still that mood of service will keep us propelling forwards on the spiritual level. And thus, we will move towards Krishna. And even if we lose everything materially, even if we lose all our abilities, all our possessions, still the soul can connect with Krishna. And that destiny is bigger than the biggest adversity. No adversity can rob us of our spiritual identity. No adversity can rob us of our spiritual destiny unless we get caught in material consciousness. If we stay spiritually conscious, then we stay spiritually progressive. The Bhagavad Gita explains this in 6.22. Yam labdhva chaparam labham manyate nadhikam tataha yasmin sthitona dukhena gurunapi vichalyate. So once we become spiritually realized, yasmin sthito, that what is the sthito? That when we become situated in spiritual consciousness, yam labdhva, when we attain that consciousness, then dukhena, even if great distresses come, gurunapi vichalyate, no, we will not be disturbed. So while we can try to develop our talents and we can try to increase our position in the world, the most important thing we need to do is increase our spirituality, because therein lies our supreme security, a security that no adversity can take away from us, a future, a destiny that no adversity can rob from us. That is what our spirituality offers us if we develop our spirituality, if we become spiritually conscious. Thank you. Hare Krishna.